Hello, everybody. My name is Michele DiPietro. I am the Executive Director of the Center for Excellence in Teaching and Learning at Kennesaw State University, where I work with faculty and graduate students to help them refine their teaching. I'm also an Associate Professor in the Department of Statistics, where I teach a variety of graduate and undergraduate courses. But my real passion is actually learning. I'm fascinated by how people learn, and that is why I have devoted a significant chunk of my career to researching the learning process. And when I was at Carnegie Mellon with my colleagues there, we authored a book called How Learning Works, Seven Research-Based Principles for Smart Teaching, where we actually synthesized the literature, 50 plus years of research into learning, from a variety of perspectives, cognitive, motivational, developmental, from diversity and inclusion, from organizational learning, into seven interrelated principles that explain what matters when students are trying to learn something, what determines how deep they will be able to go into that learning process. So one of them really has to do with what Derek was talking about, misconceptions. So we've seen a story about misconceptions in math, but actually misconceptions abound in every field. They were first documented in physics, but ever since then we have a strong catalog. So for instance, we have misconceptions in astronomy, where some students believe that the seasons are caused by the elliptical orbit of the Earth around the sun. We see misconceptions in geology when some students say that they believe the Earth is 6,000 years old. We see misconceptions in statistics. I see this all the time when students behave as if association implies causation. They might even be able to tell me that association does not imply causation, but then they reason as if it did. And then we see a lot of misconceptions in physics about velocity and acceleration, electricity, and many more phenomena, natural phenomena. We see misconceptions in neuroscience about the brain. For instance, the idea that the left brain is more linear and the right brain is more creative. So just take a second, if you will, to think about what is one typical misconception that students might have about a topic that you teach in your discipline.